respected Shri Gitesh Sharma ji, Srinivas ji, distinguished guests, participants of the conference in the Kendra, Delhi, and those joining us through video conferencing from Indian and Russian cities. A very good afternoon to all of you. On behalf of the Medical Council of India, I take this opportunity to extend our gratitude to the Ministry of External Affairs for organizing the Indian-Russian Students' Conference. The erstwhile Soviet Union and the present-day Russian Federation has been an important destination for Indian citizens to acquire medical qualifications. Every year, hundreds of students have been going to Russia to become doctors. The term primary medical qualification means a minimum qualification that is sufficient for enrollment on any state medical register or for entering the name in the Indian medical register. And it is only then a person is able to practice in India. For the Indian medical graduate, this is MBBS, which is the primary medical qualification. Whereas for students graduating from Russia, it is MD physician. Now, I just want to briefly go over our requirements because we still keep getting a lot of queries, as well as there are a lot of problems concerned with the issuance of the eligibility certificate and the screening test regulations. So I just want to go briefly over it. The provisions relating to the eligibility certificate and screening test were incorporated in the Indian Medical Council Act 1956. Partly these provisions have their genesis in the disintegration of the Soviet Union. It was found that in the 90s, a large number of private agencies had sponsored students for medical studies in institutions outside India for commercial considerations. Such students also included those students who did not fulfill the minimum requirements for admission to medical courses in India. Therefore, due to lack of uniformity in the standards of medical education in various foreign countries, it was decided that a provision should be included in the Indian Medical Council Act 1956 so as to enable MCI to conduct a screening test in order to satisfy itself with regard to the adequacy of knowledge and skills acquired by students of India who had obtained medical qualifications from universities or medical institutions outside India before they were granted practicing rights. Further, the issue of prior eligibility certificate by the Medical Council of India would ensure that only those students who had the minimum qualification for admission in colleges, in medical colleges in India, were allowed to go abroad to obtain medical qualifications. So in terms of Section 13(4)(a) and 13(4)(b), which were included in the Indian Medical Council Act 1956 by way of amendment in 2001, two main requirements were introduced. One, the applicant who is a citizen or an overseas citizen of India must have obtained an eligibility certificate from the MCI, which would confirm that the applicant meets the minimum eligibility requirement for admissions in India. This included that the candidate should have completed 17 years of age on or before 31st of December of the year of admission. And secondly, should have passed 10 plus 2 from a recognized board as a regular student and should have studied physics, chemistry, biology or biotechnology together as subjects. Such a person should have obtained more than 50% marks taken altogether in these subjects with passing marks in English. The council does not accept those who have passed 10 plus 2 from the National Institute of Open Schooling or state open schools or even private candidates. For reserved category students, the threshold is 40% instead of 50%. Further, the study of biology as an additional subject for 1 year is not permissible as per the MCI policy and rules. The council and the government have recently agreed to make national eligibility entrance test from May 2018 mandatory for even those students who wish to go and study medicine abroad. The Act also provides that the eligibility certificate is required to be taken before going abroad. However, many students have gone abroad without taking the eligibility certificates, and this they do so at their own peril because when they come back, they are not eligible to sit for the screening test. Therefore, students going abroad are advised to check that the medical qualifications granted by the foreign medical institutions in which he or she wished to take admission is recognized for the purpose of enrollment as a medical practitioner in that particular country. From time to time, we have been receiving lists of medical institutions from Indian embassies of various countries, which we post on our website. So I would like to inform that an Indian university, recently we had this case that an Indian university had opened a medical school in Thailand, and about 55 students had passed out from there. But this university was never recognized by the Thai authorities. Therefore, when those students came back to India, they could not appear for the screening test. And it just destroyed their career. Thirdly, I would say that on return, an applicant is, since they are required to apply for the sit for the screening test conducted by the National Board of Examination, the form required for filling up of the screening test also requires, it has a clause for eligibility certificate. So therefore, this certificate is really mandatory before a person decides to go abroad to study. The screening test that is conducted by NB is based on MBBS curriculum and it is a multiple choice based question exam. The pass percentage, however, in this exam it is seen is not very high. As far as the Russia and Commonwealth of Independent States is concerned, the NBE figures show that between 2012 and 2014, out of 5,950 candidates that had appeared for the exam, only 1,094 could clear the exam, which is only an 18.4%. Now, once a foreign medical graduate has qualified the screening test, the primary medical qualification that is acquired by such a person from the medical institution situated abroad deemed to be a recognized medical qualification for the purposes of the IMC Act. And such a person can then get himself enrolled on the state medical register, which the state councils do after due scrutiny and grant him provisional or permanent registration as the case may be. Now, certain issues have been flagged as areas of concern for the MCI, where the council does not recognize migration of students from one medical institution to another. The council regulations requires that applicants who have taken admission after 16th of April 2010 are required to obtain their primary medical qualifications by completing the entire duration of the course from the same medical institution. This provision has been made in the screening test regulations because it came to the notice of the council that many fly-by-night operators were taking students for a ride and cheating them, and they had opened teaching shops in some parts of India and were getting them degrees from foreign countries. Certain examples are of universities situated in St. Kitts and Nevis, Tanzania, Seychelles and so on. It was found that such students did not have any clinical or academic exposure. This provision was, although it was challenged in the Honorable High Court of Delhi, but it was quashed, and the council had then preferred an SLP before the Supreme Court, and even the Apex Court had directed that all candidates taking admission in medical courses in foreign countries after 16th of April 2010 are required to complete the entire duration of the course in the same institute itself. They cannot change the institute midway. Therefore, it is imperative upon those who go abroad that they should carefully verify the credentials of the universities or medical institutions before they take any admission. There were certain other problems that MCI has been, it has been brought to the notice of the MCI, and they are under consideration of both the Indian Embassy and the Council. We had received a representation from about 150 students who had joined a state medical university in the Russian Federation through an agent in 2016. According to them, there's another set of 150 students who had also joined through some other agent who was probably quite close to the college authorities. The first set of 150 students, suddenly from the onset of second year, had been started being taught in Russian instead of English as they were promised earlier, while the other set of students were being taught in English. So these students, the first set, had made a request to us to allow them to continue from second year onwards in some other medical institutions. Another kind of situation that we have come across is that medical institutions in Russia have been expelling Indian students in large numbers after completion of the second or third year of studies. The Indian Embassy had informed us that such students were expelled due to a nexus between the so-called educational consultants and the university authorities whose commercial interests superseded the students' careers. The Embassy had asked us to take a compassionate view in this case and permit them to shift to other institutions in Russia. Faced with such situations, the council has removed the name of the medical institution from the list that is placed on our website. However, as per our regulations, we cannot allow transfer midway. The above request is not permissible, as I have already said. The MCI, or for that matter, the Indian government, does not have any control over the affairs of foreign medical institutions. So we have requested the embassy to resolve this issue through their diplomatic efforts. Migration, even in India, the council does not appreciate migration from one college to another, and it is only allowed under exceptional circumstances, and that too within 1 month of passing of first MBBS. And during clinical phase of teaching, we generally do not allow at all. However, in certain, there has been an exception to this rule also, where a recent amendment was made in the screening test regulations, allowing the council to relax this requirement of obtaining medical education from the same institute located abroad. The exception was in the case of students from Crimea, where the life of the students was under distress. So in conditions of war, civil unrest, rebellion, internal war, any such situation, there is an exception in the regulation which does allow migration of students even midway. I would also take this opportunity to inform everyone present here that under the statutory scheme, the postgraduate medical qualifications that are obtained from the Russian Federation and the CIS countries are not recognized under the IMC Act. Therefore, on the strength of such a qualification, a person is not entitled to practice as a specialist in the country. In order to facilitate inquiries from Indian students, we have introduced a helpline which works from 9:30 to 6 on Monday, between Mondays to Friday, where the students can seek our assistance. They can also drop us an email anytime and their queries will be definitely answered. With regard to what Mr. Vaseem had just said about eligibility certificates being made online, that is already under process. We have initiated a digital mission mode project, and this is a part of it. So soon the eligibility certificates would be made online for the convenience of the students. Thank you so much for giving.